constitution of the willingness to take, with understanding and with joy, whatever the future may bring. It may also involve the restitution of harmonious relations with the patient's surroundings, with family and friends, and the consequent result of renewed correct adjustment, an uprising of a spirit of love and the negation of what may have been deep-seated wrong thinking. It will be apparent to you, therefore, that the process of following a healing ritual is only one phase of the work to be done, and that the relation of healer and patient is basically an educational one. It must be an education tempered by the physical condition of the sick person. You will find, as you work along these lines, that it will be necessary to have short expositions of the work to be done, of the restitutions which the patient must be prepared to make in order to facilitate the inflow of the healing force. He must be induced to clean his slate, if I may use such a symbolic phrase, that the work of healing is to be successful under the law of karma. This phase of the preparatory work is not easy. With patients who may be grievously ill, it may not be possible. It will be found by all healing agencies that when working with those who are spiritually minded and those whose lives have for a long time been based upon right effort and a correct, rendering unto Caesar the things which are Caesar's and unto God the things which are God's, that the work of healing will be greatly accelerated, or, on the other hand, that the task of smoothing the way through the gates of death will be greatly simplified. After all, death is in itself a work of restitution. It involves the work of rendering back of substance to the three worlds of substance, and doing it willingly and gladly. It involves also the restoration of the human soul to the soul from whence it emanated, and doing this in the joy of reabsorption. You must all learn to look upon death as an act of restitution. When you can do this, it will take on new light and true meaning and become an integral part, recognized and desired, of a constant living process. If I were asked to say what is the major task of all healing groups, such as the hierarchy seeks to see functioning in the future, I would say it is to prepare human beings for what they should regard as the restorative aspect of death, and thus give to that hitherto dreaded enemy of mankind a new and happier significance. You will find that if you work along these indicated lines of thought, the entire theme of death will constantly recur, and that the result of this will be new attitudes to dying and the implication of a happy expectancy where that inevitable and most familiar event occurs. Human beings must prepare to deal with this phase of condition of all living, and a major part of their work will be the elucidating of the principle of death. The soul, we are told, must return to the one who gave it. To date there has been an enforced and dreaded restitution, one which engenders fear and which leads men and women everywhere to clamor for the healing of the physical body, overemphasizing its importance and making them regard the prolongation of earthly existence as the most important factor in their lives. During the next cycle, these wrong attitudes must come to an end. Death will become a normal and understood process. As normal as the process of birth, will evoking less pain and fear. This comment of mine is in the nature. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. 231. The Treatise on the Seven Rays. Volume 4. Esoteric Healing. Of a prophecy and should be noted as such. I would, therefore, enjoin upon you the elementary fact that any human group seeking to work along the new lines must, as a preliminary to the general.